is Kepler's laws of planetary motion. Three laws are there. So first you understand what is ellipse. This shape is known as ellipse. And you understand that there are two axes. This one is known as your major axis. This is the major axis. And this one is minor axis. Two focus is there, F1 and F2. F1 and F2, two focus, that is in your major axis. So according to Kepler's laws of motion, the first law is every planet revolves around the sun in an elliptical orbit. You see the picture, P is your planet and this is the orbit of the planet and this picture is ellipse. So every planet revolves around the sun in an elliptical orbit with the sun situated at one of the foci of the ellipse. There are two focus, this one and this one. So foci is the plural form. So sun is situated at one of the foci of the ellipse. This is the first law. Second law, the line joining the planet and the sun sweeps equal areas in equal interval of time. Now you see the picture, this is the position of sun and your planet is moved first from A to B. And whatever time is taken by the planet, suppose 1 month. So planet takes 1 month from move A to B. Join both the lines from the sun and area is your OAB. This area will cover. And suppose same 1 month will taken from C to D, then this area OCD, both areas will be equal. So the time taken by the planet to move from A to B, that is equal to the time taken by the planet to move from C to D. Then area of OAB is equal to area of OCD. This is the second law. The Kepler's third law. Suppose this is your position of sun and this is planet. So planet moves around the sun in an elliptical orbit. This is the movement of planet. Every planet takes some time to revolve around the sun. Okay. So we move the sun in this position at one of its focus. Now this planet will take time capital T. Capital T time taken by this planet to move around this elliptical orbit around the sun. And the mean distance from the sun to the planet. This is the mean distance that we assume R. So R is the distance, mean distance, okay, from the sun to the planet. And T is the time taken by the planet to take revolution around the sun. Then according to Kepler's third law, R cube is directly proportional to T square. This is the third law of motion. Now how can we define the cube of mean distance of a planet from the sun, that is R. This is the mean distance, is directly proportional to the square of its orbital period capital T. R cube is directly proportional to T square.